Hello, Internet peoples. My name is Caleb Durward, here recording a cube draft for channelfireball.com. Now, this pack's interesting. We got a Ronam Unicorn here, that's probably my pick. We got a Blastoderm, that's also a strong pick here. And wait, no. There's Chase the Mind Sculptor. Okay, we're doing that. Let's see. Sort of body and mind, control magic. Control magic. Oh, I love control magic. They play their guy, you play your guy, they trade, then they play their best guy, and then you take it, and then you have the best guy on the board. I like it. It's really hard to pass a sword of body and mind. Card's really good, especially in limited. It only takes a few hits to kill someone, even if they've like gained a ridiculous amount of life or something, just through the mill. And then it gives you a guy each time. I have a huge nostalgia for Control Magic, though. That card's awesome. Factor Fiction You Lose is also pretty good, but like, already starting with the Jace, I'd rather have something that impacts the board. Condescend is a sweet card. I wouldn't mind second picking a Condescend if there weren't all these sweet blue cards in here. This pack's a little harder. I don't particularly want another 4-drop in Glenelinda Archmage. The card's really good, but I went like first pick 4-drop, second pick 4-drop. Legacy's Allure is a little bit clunky for Cube. It's not a very good top deck. I don't really want to draw into it. So my options are Avacyn's Pilgrim, which can help me play Jace on turn 3. Or Mana Tithe, which would put me firmly into a blue-white kind of control deck, which sounds sweet. I like that. So I'm going to third pick this Mana Tithe. It's probably correct, right? That's a show and tell. Oh my god, this pack. Draga Tree Speaker is a soul ring, basically. After turn 2, which is awesome. It's one of the more underrated cards in Cube. And it still gets picked pretty highly. Still underrated. Show and Tell is sweet. I like playing the Show and Tell deck. Just randomly kill people. They're like Goblin Guide. You're like, alright, I have an Emrakul. This was fun. Next game. Obsidet's a sweet card. The mana for Obsidet is so clunky, though. I could even see taking Glacial Fortress or the Esper Charm or the Spell Pierce here. They're all fine options. Esper Charm is particularly sweet, but we don't really know how our mana's going to end up. I'm just going to take this Glacial Fortress. Flooded Plain. Interesting. Yeah, I'm just going to take the Terminus here. This is a scary pack for us because it includes like Plow Under, which is not really a card that we want to face. But oh well. Terminus is interesting. I haven't played with Terminus in a cube deck yet, so be interesting to see if we can abuse it on their turn or something. Lotus Cobra. There's just too much green ramp. But a green ramp is going too late. There's a Thoughtseize in here too. Man. That's exciting. Yeah, I'm just gonna take this Lotus Cobra. The thought of like a turn 3 Jace or what have you is pretty awesome. I could also like take a wall, just like cantrip into my land drops and have a big wall. Walls are sweet. Delver and Mana Tithe could like make the core of a tempo deck to like cut the Terminus. I'll take the Cobra though. Alright, what am I doing here? Edge of Autumn could also lead to a turn 3 Jace. Selesnya Sanctuary has some interesting synergy with Lotus Cobra. I think I'll take the Edge of Autumn. It's close though. Knight of the White Orchid. Yeah, I'll take that. Crit's fine. I could take Shardless Agent and then maybe cut white so I don't like cascade it into Manatithe. Just be this blue-green kind of value deck. Or I could play all the colors and play this Behemoth Sledge. Sledge is real good. I kind of miss having a Loxodon Warhammer. As much as I hated losing to Loxodon Warhammers in Limited, I enjoyed having them in Constructed play. Shroud and Vanishing. Do I want a white Blastoderm? Or do I want this Yawgmoth's Will? Probably not playing this Yawgmoth's Will. I mean, I have Lotus Cobra. I can play anything. Yeah, I'll take the Calcederm. Spell Pierce. Pretty happy about that. Wheeling Playables is the best feeling ever in Cube, because all the cards are sweet, so you didn't just, like, wheel this 23rd card or whatever. You wheeled this card that'll help you fill out the actual curve of your deck. Let's see. Take this Life from the Loam in case I sack into a Strip Mine or something. Strip Mine's real good. I love that card. Like, last pick a playable green card. Probably means that green is more open than this white that I started picking early. Days. I love Days. Brainstorm without any shuffle effects is less awesome. I guess I have one. The Edge of Autumn is technically a shuffle effect. Fertile Ground is nice. I could have, like, another way of turn 3 and Jace, but I'm just gonna take this Daze here. Yeah. It seems strange taking a Daze this highly when there's, like, all these Planeswalkers here. I guess Mox Diamond is also an option. Mox Diamond could be really good, actually, because we already have a Loam in our deck. Kind of makes me wish I'd taken Polluted Delta over this Glacial Fortress in the last pack. On the other hand, you're pitching a land, so that's one less land for Lotus Cobra. That's interesting. I've been really happy with Daze in the past in this cube. Like, people have pretty large curves that they have to just keep slamming things into, but I haven't actually played with Mox Diamond much in this cube, so I'm going to try it. They're both pretty mediocre with Shardless Agent Cascades and such. Emrakul, so if we'd taken that Show and Tell, we'd have the sweet two-card combo now. Maybe that makes me just want to, like, take the card that destroys that and just, well, I have this Sower of Temptation. Definitely like it better than either of these four drops. Yeah, this pack. I've kind of wished that I'd taken that Thoughtseize earlier. Then I could take this Grave Titan here and just have a really good deck. I could probably still take the Grave Titan, but it's more powerful than the Sower. It'd be another color, and I don't really want to do that right now. I think I'm just going to take this Sower. Resto Angel is an option, but I don't really have anything good to blink, so I'm not going to do that either. Yep. Not really complaining, like, Sower of Temptation is awesome, so. Could take that Natural Order and hope to do something sweet. Could I actually take, like, Yosei or Void Mage Prodigy? Void Mage Prodigy, sack my Sower and my Delver. It's a Human Rogue. Not too happy about seeing a Hellrider in this pack. Yeah, I'm going to take this Natural Order, even though we're, like, into pack 2, and I've got like two green creatures that are worth sacrificing. Who knows? Maybe I'll see the Progenitus. Forbid. That's a card. Into the Royal is also a card. I like both of these cards. What am I going to do? Oh, Forbid and Life from the Loam. That's a combo. Could turn two an Oran Viper. That might be good. I don't know if it's better than Tarmogoyf, though. Trying to think about how fast Tarmogoyf grows in this format, because I haven't played it in this cube much. Its direction's also a card. I didn't get any of those green ramp guys, so the odds of turn two-ing a Viper are not as good as they could be. Tarmogoyf, though. Tarmogoyf has a lot of potential to grow in this deck. It's got, like, artifacts and spells and planeswalkers. I'm just going to take the Goyf. Mind's Desire. Mind's Desire. Desire looks like the most difficult thing to get off in this cube ever. Best of in Shapeshifter is hot. I remember when that card was just bonkers. It's standard. And then it was, the original version was pretty insane too. It didn't have more for anything, it just came into play as, yeah, that card was good. I'm taking the Sphere of the Suns though. I wouldn't blame anyone for taking the Giant Solifuge here. It's really good in the control mirrors, control-ish type mirrors. A lot of decks in Cube end up blending archetypes together, so you end up with this like aggro control deck and aggro combo and all that. All the different range of the... So all these good red creatures are going late. We saw a Hellrider, like just a single Hellrider sticking out of a pack. Now there's like Figure of Destiny and Zealous Conscripts going late. But I think that's just the direction of the pack. I think the guy to the right of me is a red drafter, and then next pack I'll start seeing all these sweet green cards again. Serendib's a fine guy. I like that card. Take him. This is interesting. I got an Edric if I wanted to like try and flip my Delver and draw some sweet cards. If I had some mana guys, that's definitely what I'd be doing. I think I'm going to take the Simic Growth Chamber, because I don't actually have much fixing at all, which is awkward. I'm still kind of expecting to cut white, so... The day's tabled! So did the Fertile Ground. That's awesome. I'm excited. Well, if I daze their guy, I'm putting a land back in my hand for Mox Diamond. Synergy! Yeah, I'm just going to do that. Fertile Ground's nice, but it's an accelerant that isn't a creature for Natural Order, so... Not that I have anything sweet to get with Natural Order anyway. What am I doing here? I could just, like... accept the variants and go Bant. I guess Mox Diamond's a fixer. Edge of Autumn's technically a fixer. Lotus Cobra's a fixer. Sphere. I mean, mana's not miserable. Could probably support the third color. I think it's better than Fathom Seer. Yeah, I'll take that Bant Charm. that's scary this late. Cataclysm. Leave just like my Tarmogoyf. Makes me sack my Jace though. I don't like that. Take this Fairy Conclave. Manlands are always sweet, right? I guess this is just hating from the next guy. Well, I do like hating, so I'll take this Putrid Imp. I guess I'll read this wall of text. Now let's hear it. You may have it. Enter the battlefield as a copy of any creature in the battlefield, except it's still a ninja. Oh, that's a clone. That's awesome. which of these do I not want to face? I guess the Stupor. Last pick here of Oxid Ridge. Yeah, the ninja clone. You'd think I would have seen that during that draft format.